Hi guys, welcome back to Aarti Vlog. So before starting this interesting video about what you can carry to Australia and what you can't, I would like to share something with you all.
So when you're traveling for the first time to Australia, or even if you're traveling on tourist visa or for whatever reason it may be, there are going to be luggage restrictions and it may be difficult for you to which items you should be packing and which items you should be leaving behind.
So I have a solution for this. You don't have to worry at all about the high international shipping rates, or if you are in Australia and you want to shop something and want your items to be picked from anywhere in India,
you have to definitely visit shopray.com.
So shopray.com offers a pickup service from anywhere in India,
and you can ship items hassle-free anywhere in the world,
and that too at extremely good rate. So you can order items that you don't get in Australia or any other country, like, you know, brands such as Lakme or Kama Ayurveda or any other brand.
So this website is going to be like super useful for me, wherein I can order all my Indian outfits from Amazon, Myntra, and ship it here. Since, you know, it's all expensive here in Australia, it's better to get it shipped from India.
All you have to do is just visit shoprate.com today and you're all sorted out.
So the link is in the description. Make sure to check out their website from the link below. We are very sorry guys that it's been long that we have not posted a video, and finally there is a video for you all, and this is a very informative video and hope this helps.
So guys, moving to a new country could be very challenging, and especially if you are immigrating or even traveling on travel visa, it could be tempting to take many different things with you. Today we are going to talk about those items which you should rethink before packing your luggage.
So we are going to share our experience, like what should you pack for Australia and what you shouldn't. Before we were landing to Australia, we got a slip like thing which is called as a passenger card, wherein you had to declare the items that you were carrying into Australia.
Well guys, this card and declaration on this card is very important, because this is an opportunity which is given to you by the immigration people of Australia to declare what things you're carrying, and then it is their duty whether to allow you to take these items into Australia or they need to be disposed of.
So guys, you need to be truthful on what you are carrying into Australia. So there are sniffer dogs, x-ray machines,
and there is no way you can escape.
So our suggestion would be, if you are unsure about any particular item or anything, just declare it. So here is an incoming passenger card that you get once you are landing into Australia, and this is how it looks like. So you have to fill in information like your name, surname, and passport number, flight number.
And one more thing guys, you need to also mention over here your intended address in Australia. So if you're coming for the first time, remember to get an address. Maybe it may be of your friend or it may be of your relative. And if you don't know anybody in Australia, then you can give any hotel address. So guys, there are many things which you need to declare, and medicines, then your cigarettes, if you're carrying any, how much of cash you're carrying, and what are the food items you're carrying. The reason why I'm saying this is an important document, because you're going to sign this declaration, which you can see at the bottom of the page one, which says the information I have given is true, correct, and complete. I understand failure to answer any questions may have serious consequences. So guys, make sure that you read this document carefully and declare anything if you are unsure about.
So the question comes, what will happen if you don't declare your item?
So guys, if you fail to declare anything, then you may be liable to pay hefty penalties, which can extend up to $525,000. And there could be also imprisonment, which can extend up to 10 years. Or you may be liable to both fines as well as imprisonment.
Or even your visa can get cancelled. So the rules are very strict here. So for medicines, you either need to have a prescription or a letter from your doctor, and the quantity of the medicine should not exceed more than 3 months. And it's better to keep the medicines in its original packaging only.
Next, let's talk about food items.
Products such as dairy, milk, sweets, seeds, fresh fruits are not allowed into Australia. So guys, there is a small confusion whether you can carry dairy products or not. Some people say, and it is also in the website, that you can't carry dairy products. But there is one point that I noticed in the website, that you can carry dairy products for your personal use, and the packaging should have the origin of the country, name of the country, and it should be commercially prepared and packaged. Food items like, you know, MTR products that you get, or those Maggi instant soups and all, those are allowed, because we did carry that. So instant food items are allowed. I also carried a kitchen knife with me. It was nicely packed. It was like commercially packed knife. And I had also declared it, and they did not even remove it or didn't have any issue with that, and I got it to Australia from India.
Even the items like chicken, beef, pork, meat pickle, dried beef, etc. They are also prohibited from getting into Australia.
So guys, you're also not allowed to bring dry fruits, nuts. Also, if your parents are traveling to Australia or your mom is traveling to Australia and she's wearing a nice gajra, you know, flowers on her hair, please make sure to, you know, throw it away, because here it is not allowed at all. So be careful about that as well. Items such as, you know, artificial flowers, some gold coins, silver coins, or photo frame. So you can get it, but you need to declare it. So while traveling to Australia, the food that you get in the flight, like, you know, chips, nuts, or sandwiches, or any other food items, juices, whatever you get, in case you're full and if you're planning to, you know, pack up those items and put in your bag and then eat aramse later on in the hotel or at home, sorry guys, that is not at all allowed, because whatever you get in the plane, you have to eat there or leave there.
So guys, baseline would be, if you're unsure about what you're carrying and whether it will be allowed in Australia or not, the best thing would be to declare it.
It's better to declare than be sorry later on.
Absolutely.
So guys, I had carried garam masala with me. You can check out my video what all I packed for Australia. So I had carried garam masala with me. It was around 2 kgs of each packet, which I had packed properly. This, you can get items in powder form. And guys, I had declared it, so there was no problem at all in getting garam masala. I had also carried turmeric powder with me, organic turmeric powder with me, and as well as garam masala. So yeah, I didn't have any issues with that.
Also guys, the biosecurity laws over here, they are so strict that even mud on your footwear and sand contamination on any of the items which you are carrying, it may be anything, it may be your clothes or your footwear or any other accessories, they are viewed so seriously that they pose a big threat to the Australian biodiversity.
So my tip here would be, like, you know, before traveling to Australia, do wash your footwear, make it, like, you know, super clean, and then only wear and come to Australia. So even if you're carrying any wood items like a showpiece or anything, it should be processed.
So guys, if you want to carry such things, then go to the department website and check out how and what are the steps or procedures you need to follow in order to carry these items into Australia.
So I'm providing the link, you can check it out in my description box. Gold jewelry also is allowed into Australia, but you have to declare it. Gold and silver items you can carry, your if you are from India, you can carry your mangalsutra, you can carry your ring, some earrings, and, you know, bangles. You can carry everything, but not too much.
And as far as cash is concerned, you can carry a maximum of $10,000 in cash. Anything above it, you have to declare it. As far as alcohol bottles are concerned, guys, you are allowed to carry only what you are eligible to carry as per the duty-free allowance. In case if you are caught carrying excess bottles, then you may be liable to pay for the entire bottles or items which you're carrying with yourself. Also guys, one more thing which we would like to suggest you would be to be aware of what you're carrying, because sometimes it may so happen that you may be totally unaware of what is there in your pockets, or you may accidentally keep something in your bag, especially the food items which are given to you during your flight journey. So please be careful, please check your pockets, check your bags, and make sure that you
remove the items in the plane there itself.
Absolutely.
And also, in case you have eaten a biscuit or anything and you have just, you know, your pocket has those crumbs and all, small particles of biscuits, also be careful of that, because there are dogs who come to sniff around. You might be caught for no reason. So I hope this video was super, super helpful for everyone who want to travel or who will be traveling to Australia in the future. Please also like this video and subscribe to my channel if you haven't as of now, and also press the bell icon which is besides it, so that you get notified each and every time when I upload a new video.
And also don't forget to share Aarti vlogs with your contacts. Till then, bye bye, see you and take care.
Take a picture now.
Put on the chair.